The September 11th, 2001 terrorist attacks had a great impact on most Americans. 18-year-old Martin Kondor of Yorkana, York County, was one of them.
Martin decided that he needed to join the military and help protect the country.
Martin Kondor was popular at Eastern York High School, where he was elected president of his class one year. Martin's dad described his son as someone who wasn't afraid of a challenge. After joining the Army, Martin went through basic training, was stationed in Germany, and eventually volunteered to be a bodyguard for a high-ranking officer in Iraq. Martin was in Iraq only a few months when he was killed by an improvised explosive device on April 29, 2004. Soon afterwards, two soldiers appeared on the Kondor's front porch.
And you just run through a thousand different scenarios in your head, you know, when you lose a child like that. And I don't know, you just kind of shut down and try to be supportive to the rest of the family. You know, you feel like you have that responsibility. There's just no easy way to deal with it.
After Martin was killed, his wristwatch was sent to his parents as part of his personal effects. Mike put it in the top drawer of his dresser and heard the alarm that Martin had set go off one night and many nights after that.
Here it is. It would be 6 o'clock and he'd be getting up to do his normal routine, which for him at that time was they would have to drive into the city of Bakuba or the surrounding areas, and the colonel would meet with tribal leaders and, you know, try to keep things under control. And every day he did that, there were insurgents who were trying to kill the colonel, and they would be the victim of sniper attacks and roadside bombs and rocket-propelled grenades. You just have to think how difficult that must have been to face that every day of that you're there.
It's been 7 years since Martin Kondor's death. Every day is Memorial Day for Mike and his wife, but there are times when he has painful thoughts of his son.
You think about what's been lost there, that, you know, potential grandchildren and, you know, it's just a life lost. That's the thing that you think about the most.
Like other parents who lost loved ones in battle, Mike and Cher Kondor grieved, but it wasn't enough. So Cher decided to honor Martin and other fallen soldiers in another very ambitious way. The Veterans Memorial Gold Star Healing and Peace Garden will be constructed at Veterans Memorial Park in York.
This is the official design for the Gold Star Garden, and it is made in a circle to promote unity, and it will feature a double row of pleached hornbeam trees around the outside so that it's a little bit separate from the rest of the park. And then there'll be a series of garden rooms or spaces, each planted with a certain color that reflects a core value. On the arms of the Star Walk, we'll have our special feature that will be a low wall that will contain the names of the fallen in the War on Terror. So the first wall you come to will be the York County fallen from the time of the Gold Star Mothers. That would be World War I on. And then we'll go on to all those in the U.S. that have fallen in the War on Terror. I would like this to promote healing on an individual level. The root word of healing is to make whole. So if we can have wholeness on an individual level, they can take that back to the family unit, the community, and hopefully out into the world.
For Smart Talk, I'm Scott LaMar.